Stocks on Wall Street falling Friday afternoon after Apple said it's temporarily shutting some stores in states where infections are on the rise. Perhaps it's a chance for investors to buy on the dips. Well, what should they look for? Let's ask Ryan Payne, president of Payne Capital Management, joining me from New York City. Welcome back, Ryan. Good seeing you.
Good to see you, Fred, virtually.
Same here. Different world, but you're looking cool. Now, one class of stocks that you like in this environment are cyclicals, which had been all of a sudden catching up to big cap growth stocks until Thursday when stocks really took a drubbing. Why do you like cyclicals now?
Well, because cyclicals indicative of economy that's recovering, and that's essentially what we're seeing right now, right? You look at the economic data starting to get better, and if you just look at how beaten down cyclicals got when the market sold off, and since we saw that trough on March 23rd, a lot of cyclicals are starting to outperform tech. I mean, energy specifically has just had the best run in the entire market, but consumer discretionary has done really well, materials, industrials, so all of that looks very good on a valuation standpoint. I mean, the spread between growth and value right now, Fred, is as big as I've ever seen in my career.
So good time to get into cyclicals as you see it. Another class that you like, Ryan, small caps. And they have been long underperforming big caps, and they're underperforming today as well against the NASDAQ and S&P. So why small?
Well, small caps, again, when you have an economic recovery, tend to do better than large caps. It's just because when their revenue goes up, it has a much bigger impact. There's more leverage there. So small caps, again, they've underperformed this year versus what large cap growth has done specifically. And if you look at that trough again on March 23rd, you know, they've done really, really well. At one point, they were surpassing large cap stocks, and that trend should continue as the economy recovers.
Would you like to put the two together, let's say cyclicals within small caps?
I mean, if you look at small cap value specifically, yes, that's actually the best performer. If you look over the last 100 years, small cap value actually outperforms every other asset class. And it's much cheaper than just a small cap blend that has that growth component in there. So absolutely, if you don't just want to, you know, get down and look at small cap value as an isolated asset class, which we do with our portfolios, it's just like one of the best buys you've ever had in history.
All right, now, Ryan, with this upcoming weekend being Father's Day, I can't let you go without asking you about your particular relationship with your dad, because unlike other, you know, sons who worked for their fathers and then the family-run firm, you and your dad, Bob, co-founded the firm together. So what's it like working with your dad, and what's the best investing tip that he gave you, or maybe you gave him?
Well, we're 13 years in, and I don't want to jinx it, but it's the best relationship I have in my life. I mean, he's my father, gives me guidance that way. We're partners in business and friends. So to have all three of those aspects with your dad and to create something together, we're one of the fastest growing investment advisory firms in the industry, and we started it from scratch together, is a pretty cool thing. And when it comes to wisdom, my dad, Bob, has a lot of wisdom. In fact, at our firm, we call him Bobisms because he has so much wisdom. And I think one of the smartest pieces of advice he ever gave me, or two pieces of advice, are number one, there's no smart pessimist when it comes to investing. And so, you know, the market goes up about 85% of the time. So trying to bet that the market's going to go down, and this is a perfect example of that kind of market where there's been a lot of naysayers as this market's come off the bottom, and a lot of people haven't believed in it, but the market keeps going higher and higher. So I think being an optimist when you're an investor is critical. The other thing he's always said to me, and this is actually in our career has been very important advice, is it's okay to be wrong, but it's not okay to stay wrong. So when you make a bad decision, that's fine, but you got to change course. And I think a lot of investors right now sitting in cash thinking we were going to get this big dip down in the market again, it's okay, you were wrong, but don't stay wrong. You know, the economy is getting better. We talked about valuations on small cap stocks, cyclicals. There's so many places you can put your money right now that are great for the long term. So it's okay to be wrong. Don't stay wrong. Get invested.
Or at one point, I guess, if you go another generation, there are going to be Ryanisms.
Oh, man. I'm not that old yet. I hope not. But
just looking ahead.
When I do, I'll be there with my, you know, my big beard, drinking a scotch, and espousing wisdom, I hope.
All right. That time will come. Well, for your clients, I guess it's, in your company's case, no pain, no gain, right?
No true words can be spoken, Fred.
All right, as long as you're optimistic. All right, thanks a lot, Ryan. Appreciate it.
Thanks, Fred.
Our thanks to Ryan Payne of Payne Capital Management. I'm Fred Katayama in New York. This is Reuters, and have a wonderful Father's Day weekend.